Welcome back, everyone. It's time to finally decide who will be joining the other players in Poland for the round of 16. We're down to two matches in Group D of the round of 32 here at the WCS Premier League. And the first winner's match, it will be Marine Lord versus Haas. How excited are you two about this match?
You know, as much as I think about it, you know, it's like Marine Lord obviously watched those games.
Mm-hmm.
You go into a group with Haas, you have to do some level of preparation or studying what this guy's going to throw at you. But there's just something deep down inside of me that wants to see Haas cheese the ever-loving crap out of him.
I mean, Rotterdam, the way we saw it, clearly Ajax knew what was coming, too. And
yes.
It just seems like when it's Haas, it's not your ordinary cheese, right? It's not like, all right, well, I'll be prepared for one or two. It's like, well, okay, he cheesed. All right, and then he'll upgrade his cheese a little bit. I'll still be prepared for that. And then he's like, well, it's just another cheese within that game that keeps rolling in.
The thing is, like, of course you can mentally prepare and you can sort of expect what is going to happen. The thing is, it's not like, will he do it or will he not do it? He will do it. And he has way more experience in any crazy possible scenario than you have, because every single game that Haas plays pretty much looks like this, you know. That's just how he starts things off. And it's not like he can only do a certain risky build. If it doesn't work, then he's dead. Like, he will not just expand, but it's more just, he's always going to try to get himself in a favorable scenario by doing something very weird and risky early on. And that is the biggest danger for Marine Lord, I think.
Yeah. Now, Nate, I want to talk to you a little bit about this, because you were saying it during that cast of Haas where you said, well, just watching it, Ajax just needs to keep building bunkers, right? It's like, because you know he's going to cheese. And at that point, it's not a mind game anymore. It's just simply who's better prepared. And you were saying maybe just the best way to do it is to be 100 and 200% prepared. Do you think that's going to be the way for Marine Lord too? Or do you think he can be like, oh, well, a little bit more confident in how I play, I'm going to take it a little bit slower?
Yeah, of course. The thing is, all of the builds, like if you're someone like Haas, you're probably used to running into people. I don't imagine he plays with his actual name on ladder, but even that could be like a weird mind game of itself. You're playing against mostly on people on ladder that are going to do the normal builds, mm-hmm. maybe safe builds, maybe greedy builds, but in general, you have a variety of builds you're expecting to go against. Normally, you think to yourself, if I want to scout a proxy, I'm going to open up Reaper because I want to get a fast around on my map, see what's going on. But it's going to build gateways in your base. Yeah. Your Reaper's going to come out later than a Marine would. You want to go for something weirdly safe that won't normally be what everyone always does to defend against cheesy builds like that. And that's where the mind games come into play.
I was thinking, Nate, if I was a Terran player and I'm playing against a player like Haas, I would always go gasless fast expand. You know, just make a barracks and then drop a CC and then drop two more barracks. Isn't that pretty good against pretty much everything? That
If you know that, if you like could know, like 100% someone was going to do any of the builds that Haas has done in this series.
You wouldn't be sure right now, Nate?
Yo, let's go back to Wings of Liberty. Take me back to Cloud Kingdom. 12 barracks, 14 barracks, no gas. Build a ton of Marines. It'll give you enough to take out Oracles, and then just go for a slightly later expo, and then just try to play the game out from normal. Of course, Haas has probably played against some poor fool that's tried to do that, so he may have some other weird variety of cheese up his belt.
Yeah, I mean, it really seems that when you're playing against Haas, you're no longer playing the game you thought you knew. It's not StarCraft II Heart of the Swarm anymore. It's Haas's game, and Haas will always be the veteran in that game because, like you said, I mean, he knows all the different matchups in his own little game. It's like, all right, me versus, whether it's, you know, me versus Protoss, me versus Terran, whether it's greedy, like you said, or whether it's safe, he's going to have that experience. But at the same time, and we hype up Marine Lord for a reason, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's known as one of the top players in Europe for a good reason. He's made some good runs in the past. He's here. People are saying, I mean, sure, Jeff was telling me that maybe it's a bit of a long shot to go all the way to the finals, but if he does go there, the fact that he has a pretty good chance at BlizzCon means that so far he's racked up quite a few points.
I love Marine Lord, and I definitely think he's one of the best Terran players in Europe. But if we go back to Season 2 and we go back to the quarterfinal, Liubao also showed an overly aggressive style of Protoss versus Terran. Okay, not Haas levels of aggression, but he was still pretty much defend all in, or semi all in, you know, super committed attacks. And Marine Lord does struggle a little bit with a couple of those hard Protoss counters, so I am not sure how much he truly excels in when the games go very crazy, and you know they will go crazy against this man.
Oh man, and I love that Inkato brought this up earlier. Just looking at Haas, normally if you see a player who doesn't cheese that much and they're ready to cheese, or they just want a match versus cheese, they're pretty giddy about it. They're like, haha, I got my opponent. But for Haas, it's just like, all right, time to play another game of StarCraft 2, and that's just the way he plays this game. I mean, that's what it means to him. to play StarCraft 2 is to just try to make things absolutely as crazy as possible.
Yeah. I don't have words for the way that Haas brings out this game. You know, I think back to other players that just don't have that same level of success. You know, if you're looking at the Terran side of things, you're like, rough, but he hasn't managed to make it to the round of 16 for WCS doing crazy wonky builds. And for Marine Lord, you know, we hold him up as this great player, but those are in pretty normal games that he excels in. I have no idea how he's going to react or prepare against someone like Haas.
Yeah, and looking back to Season 2, like you said, Rotterdam, I think that's a good thing to look at.
Oh, again, boy.
That Moonlight Madness goes through, and it's the very first one. Haas is like, well, if it's going to be left alive, I'll pick it up.
I mean, if I look at the other two vetoes, I can't blame him.
Like, right.
Marine Lord vetoes Bridgehead and Dash Terminal. Can you really fault him? Like, I wouldn't want to play on those maps against Haas. Like, you don't even know where the oracles are coming from. So I guess Moonlight Madness, as you like to say, is the lesser of the evils. Right. You know, you pretty much just want to roll with it. I just hope, you know, for all the French fans out there, that he is going for a good old, let's say, barracks, make a couple Marines, CC, make two more barracks. I just feel that's good against everything. The moment you open up with a Reaper, it takes forever to build a Reaper. You have SCVs mining gas. I feel that's exactly what Haas wants to do. Because he doesn't want to win the game with his proxies. He wants to do economic damage. He wants to get slightly ahead in the economic game. And from that point on, you know, do something maybe with an Oracle follow-up or Blink Stalkers. I'm sure we are going to see some DTs this series as well. Like, it kind of has to happen.
Yeah, I mean, Nate, what do you think, especially when we're talking about the Reapers or, you know, anything like that, something that's a little bit more standard in terms of getting a little bit of early pressure, whether it's Hellions or Reapers. Generally, the whole point of them is to create a little bit of pressure.
This is our face.
That in.
These are our faces,
this is what happens when you watch Haas
play. When we watch Haas.
Yeah.
Book jump.
But with those units, I mean, do you think, yeah, just skip it straight up like we discussed earlier? Just go for the Marines, the most standard
units. It can be good, though. That's the weird thing, because you don't know what type of cheese he's going to bring. If he proxy 10 gates you outside your base and you don't SCV scout it, then your Reaper can actually just lose you the game, because then the Zealot walks in with the Stalker and the Mothership Core is flying across. You're building a reactor and it's over. But if you're up against an Oracle, then it's like, okay, well, I can kind of play versus this like normal, get my expansion, build bunkers. It's so hard to tell.
There was one last thing, and I think that Haas can actually do better with that as well. I felt his Oracle control was not flawless.
Yeah.
Like, a player who can make as many Oracles as Haas, you expect levels of, like, a Trap, for instance, you know. He's so good with Oracles and stats and stuff. Those guys, they never lose one. I actually felt that Haas took a little bit too much damage on a couple of his Oracles. He lost an Oracle on Coda. That changed everything, because he did some serious work with his second Oracle, but imagine if he had two Oracles all along. And if he steps that up as well, he will be even more scary this series.
Yeah, we'll see. I mean, I'm sure Haas, of course, has looked back at his games a little bit and said, all right, well, maybe I could have cleaned it up a little bit, make sure my road to the round of 16 is a bit easier. Everyone here, of course, as you guys saw earlier, Ayagas also wants to play in Poland for that round of 16, but these two players, that dream is the same. You want to get to the round of 16 first, then worry about how far you can go here in the WCS Premier League. Should be an exciting game.
Nate, you play Terran. If you're Marine Lord right now, what's going through your mind?
Just like, damn it, to deal with this again. Like, because you always have these weird games on ladder where you're like, I'm gonna play my normal stuff. You play versus some barcode and then just do something absolutely crazy. You never expect this sort of thing.
Yeah, well, Marine Lord has to this time. He knew coming in. To some extent, maybe that's why we're seeing Moonlight Madness get through. Everyone decide, all the Terrans are like, well, that's the map I'd rather play Haas in. I'd rather veto the others, too. Let's see what Marine Lord has prepared up against Haas. Who's going to take that first seed to bring us this winner's match? It will be Huck and In Control.
Big cheese wheel in the sky keeps on turning as Haas finds himself in the winner's match against Marine Lord, the young buck from France, who a lot of people are talking about as one of the best players in WCS. He's good, but does he have what it takes to play in these chaotic times, Chris?
I have no idea. It's Haas's time. I have no idea, and I am so very, very excited to see. Wow.
It's so crazy. Swag boy.
Is this allowed?
We'll find out soon. He might be just dragged off the stage and thrown into esports jail. I think he's fine. And look where he's going immediately. We got introduced to the players as part of StarCraft tradition. So our French player from Team Millennium, it is Marine Lord. Tripped up there for a second because I thought of calling him Malord, but...
Malayede.
That's exactly right.
And in the bottom left, the man of cheese, it is Haas. Or Haas. Depending on how you want to say his name.
both these players, by the way, right now, it's not a big deal. Hmm. But they're both like starting to wall in on the off-ramp, the one that you cannot access unless you proxy in there or you destroy rocks.
As Terran, I kind of get it, because it's Haas. You know, the rocks might be broken down. There might be some crazy proxy. But as Protoss, what are you really looking to accomplish there? Bio is going to be there. It's going to break down those gateways pretty quickly anyways.
I guess like a floated factory, that could be something. You know, we saw that last time.
Yeah, but wouldn't you just put like a pylon-ish? Like, he's like purposely walling it so... Anytime later in mid-game, if he tries to take that third base, it's just going to cause a problem
with
unit flow and everything.
Chris.
Yeah, third
Your
base.
Your first mistake.
Third base.
You just said third base. You silly, silly buffoon. It's never going to come to that. Look, he's either going to be long dead or long won by then. And there's the probe outside the base.
This looks
Malord.
Like it might be a possible Tempest position, no?
We keep saying this. Is there any... Has he done that? Is there any reason
he's
why
done that before?
Okay,
yes. All right. He's done that before, and Greenlord's going to have a great scout here. He sees double gas. He sees six workers on each gas. He knows something is happening, but he doesn't scout. Did he scout the gateway? I don't think he saw the gateway.
No, he did not.
So it's even scarier right now. He needed to
so
do
there,
a...
There's the other reason, by the way. You just asked.
So he puts the gateway and the cyber core on the right side, and I guess Marine Lord doesn't see that, and now he throws up a bunker immediately at his ramp because he's unsure of... what exactly that is, and he thinks it's like some kind of proxy gateway.
Yeah, proxy stalkers or something like that.
But it's not, and now he's wasting 300 minerals on two supply depots and a bunker, and there's nothing there. There is absolutely nothing there. And this means possibly there's going to be a later engineering bay, later turret, and this Stargate's already halfway done. It looks like he's going to be able to scout it.
Oh my god.
Hopefully?
Well, he needs to. He's pulling up right now.
He does get it.
Does see it.
Just by the edge. And now... He should go into panic mode. He should immediately. He does throw up the engineering bay. He needs to get that turret up, but...
He's even adding an add-on to the barracks, so he's just got the one Marine.
Yeah, and this
He won't have enough.
No, he will not have enough. That turret will not be up in time, and what is he going to do? What do you do in this position? At this point,
he's
what
gotta
can you do?
He's got to apologize to the SCV families right now. He's like, guys, I'm so sorry.
There's nothing you can do. And now it's just like he's going to have such a hard time. The turret... does go up. It started, but that Oracle is almost out, and he's gonna take losses here.
The missile turret build's pretty quick, though. You know what? It might actually just finish. It's gonna just finish.
It looks like Haas actually missed chronoed on that Stargate. He missed one of the chronos and just caught it at the tail end.
Okay.
And so far, so good for Marine Lord. If he chrono boosted properly, that Oracle would have been out a lot sooner, and that would have been 6, 7, maybe even 8 SCVs before that turret got done. But all in all, it's not, it is not over at all.
Of course it's not.
More pylons, maybe a gateway, a void ray is coming out. How many void rays? I think he's going to immediately send it. I don't think he's going to wait. He knows what's happening. And two
you
more
think
gateways.
First void ray? I think he waits for the gateways.
Well, I mean, I think he's going to start being aggressive.
Okay.
You can pick off those supply depots for free. There's another supply depot on the back ramp. There's a lot of things that he can pick off for almost for free because there's just not that many units. And actually, Marine Lord's
I'm
going
guessing
for,
he won't.
You think he's going to wait?
Haas is a puncher. He waits.
He doesn't jab.
He's not a jabber.
He's Mike Tyson of the boxing.
He's got like three haymakers in him. He comes out.
And he just swings.
He's already breathing heavy because he's just like preparing himself. The guy's like, I'm going to come in swing. And he's like, do it.
I feel like that's a mistake, though. There's only... There you go. You just take free damage. You can pick off that other supply depot. He has the Oracle to scout. And there's really not that many Marines. He has nothing to be afraid of, right?
Sure. I mean, you're right. This is the better move. He's going to go ahead and pick and prod at this, which could, again, incur panic cost for Marine Lord. Does he give up this ramp position?
Yeah, and he's already supply blocked, so he can't build more Marines right now. And that could be a problem going into the next push. He does get the Widowmine out. It's not going to have range, or it shouldn't have range. And what he needs to do is he needs to attack and just hold position. If he holds position right here, right now,
which is what he's doing,
he'll do fine. And he should have that... prismatic alignment soon enough.
Yep.
And he's going to have the second voyage. So he will get... And he's actually going to get the Widowmine.
Yeah. And he's ready. About him is he's not looking at anything else, guys. he's not managing the economy at his natural or something. He's here looking at that.
Actually, there's a Reaper in his base doing damage. He hasn't lost any worker yet, but he could easily lose a few workers. He has literally nothing at home. He warps in a Stalker to defend.
That's the end of that.
The Reaper actually killed nothing. This Viking's going to... The thing about Vikings is, yes, they outrange Void Rays, but their speed isn't that high. So if it ever gets touched by a Void Ray, it will die.
Yeah.
It will die.
And it looks like this is going to be the focal point. And this is something about Haas. He'll reinforce that pylon. I think that's very interesting.
I don't get it. Like, she's if like, no. it's going to work, it's
no,
going to work.
I'm here.
It's like a confidence boost. It's like you already have a pylon. It doesn't warp in any quicker. And he's going to go for the bus. He actually gets the bunker pretty quickly. There's two Vikings, but there's just not enough here for Marine Lord. And it looks like he's going to get burned out.
No shields, no stim. No chance. The Reaper does come back. It's gonna. It's like, guys, I'm going down with this ship. I'm with you. And he's SCV's getting pulled.
He's pulling SCVs, but this is a desperation move. There's so many Stalkers. He's not even using his Void Rays yet.
Yeah, he's letting the shields regenerate on him.
And he's warping in Zealots. Zealots are saying, you know what? I'm committing here. I'm committing to a push, and I need this to tank damage.
He needs that a fourth gateway just outside the space, if you ask me.
Or a Nexus.
Really commit.
Anything doesn't matter. That is a sign of true commitment when you get a gateway.
All right, he's going to push up the ramp. The bunker not nearly finished. And Marine Lord, you're getting hazed. You've been hazed. Some people would say had. No.
Has.
It's hazed.
H-A-S-E-D.
You've been hazed. He's got nothing. SV's already pulled. He's just coming to grips with it right now. He's like, what is going on? Good game is called out. Haz is one game away from advancing first in this group. And I think that that is something that nobody saw coming. Except kind of Rotterdam, if we're being honest with ourselves, Chris. And I know it burns you up inside to say that.
God help us all when Rotterdam is right about this. And look, Marine Lord, he doesn't even know what to say.
He's shaking.
Like, he smiles and then he raises his eyebrows. He's like,
what's happening?
Yeah. You know what your mistake was, Marine Lord? You made a second command center. Big mistake.
I mean, maybe.
Big mistake. He just misread. If he scouted the gateway, if he scouted the core, that's two supply depots early game. That extra bunker not going up. He could have made more barracks. Could have put up an engineer bay a little quicker.
Yeah.
It was a misread because he didn't see that, and he immediately thought, hey, he proxy gated twice on this map. He's going to do it again, and guess what? He did not.
I guess tweeted out. He said he checked his barcode account, his being, of course, Has. He said he proxy oracled 100% of the time, and someone tweeted back and was like, LOL, and he's like, no, I'm being serious. It was 100%.
Like, literally. He went back 3 years. This guy does nothing but this build right here.
And I'll tell you what, Marine Lord is caught off guard. And this is, it's actually pretty incredible. We're laughing, we're having a good time. Hopefully you guys are as well. But to be honest, Haas has his style. He's got his niche thing. People know it's coming. But as Rotterdam said, and this is really good analysis, he has been here, guys, thousands of times before. He plays a pro gamer regime of 8 to 10 hours a day.
He's like Bane from Batman.
And this, yeah.
He was born in the cheese.
You adopted it. But he's here, and he's... So, like, Marine Lord, how many times has he faced a Void Ray bust? As a Terran player, probably 20, 25 times. That's a lot, right? No. Haz has done this thousands. It's incredible, the practice difference.
He dreams about this.
Look how, yeah. And I love the production. You guys are doing a great job going back and forth. Marine Lord looks like he is in the pressure chamber. Like, he's shaking. He's like, he just looks like a guy that's just been hazed. Then you go to Haz. Bored. Get me out of this. Ugh. I need to get back on the Korean ladder where I can do this to all of them forever.
He just wants to spread himself. It's like a disease.
It'd be funny to, you know, like there's videos of like Americans taste, you know, such and such for the first time and they videotape their reactions. It'd be like, it'd be funny to put Haz in a game with a third Nexus and be like, Haz experiences having a third base for the first time. It's like, wow, there's so much more Chrono Boost for my proxy Stargates. Jokes aside, guys, we're having a good time. Here we are. Let's talk about these players. Top left-hand side out of Taiwan. The monster, it's Haz. Crushing people with the proxies, with the chaos, with the cheese.
While looking bored. And in the bottom right, what some consider the favorite in this group, down 0-1, it is Marine Lord.
And I'll tell you what, you know, again, It's character building time for Marine Lord. You want to win WCS, you want to do really well, you got to beat people in macro games, but you also have to beat people in cheesy, quick, decisive games as well. And Marine Lord, if that's not your style, that's fine, but it is being enforced against you now. So he's down 0-1. He is in the winner's match, so it's nice. He's not facing elimination or anything like that, but does he want to face the momentum of Iagaz, who, by the way, we just saw his TBT. It looked quite sharp against a very similar style of Marine Lord.
And I just talked to Marine Lord, too, and he said he very much preferred to play Massa. He says Iagaz is actually quite good, and he wouldn't feel as comfortable playing him in that TBT matchup. But like you said, he needs to decide what kind of player he is, because you can go up against players that are like Hydra, super safe, super strong, just a great player. But pro gamers, they're like Skittles, man. You got to taste the rainbow. And
House, right.
He is the rainbow. He is that black licorice. No one wants that black licorice in their mouth. And Haas, he's just giving you no choice. Going double gas again, another pylon. And Terraform's a map that's not quite figured out. There's so many places you could proxy a Stargate on this map. It's like a Cinnabon, and he's going two layers deep, and you don't know. Is on the outside?
You're gonna get
is it in the middle?
With your analysis.
Yeah, yeah, I'm just going. I'm sugared up.
Sugar's all over
they
me
got
right
free
now.
Candy here, guys. I don't know. I'm eating Mike and Ike's
yes,
and Twizzlers
actually.
And cookies. I
worth mentioning, guys. They keep casters extremely well fed.
Players
but
too.
Yeah, the players. Oh, yeah, it's true. They get access to that
they,
as well.
They need cheese. Next time Haas comes here, I better see
cheese plates.
Cheese plates everywhere.
With his picture. And as you unfold the cheese, it's just a photograph of him underneath it.
Like, I want to buy him a can of that spray cheese, and then I want him to win a match and just spray a huge gob of it into his mouth and just devour.
Maybe
this is great. This is great. There is no Stalker out yet.
And he's with got the SCV, too.
Yes, SCV and Reaper on it. He can kill that pylon. But Haas, as Haas does, he's going to throw up, like, four pylons. Who cares? Doesn't matter to me,
been
man.
Been here, done that. He might even quadruple pylon. He just goes for the safe second one. A conservative Haas decision.
Yes. For him.
I'm surprised he didn't drop, you know, a forge, a cheeky forge, and like five pylons, but no, he's going to go with that.
He's actually going to wait? No, he does build the Oracle. I'd be surprised if he used Chrono Boost. He's probably saving it. He uses Chrono Boost, but it's not going to really be effective. It's only, oh, well, pylon finishes. He's actually in great position.
Chris, just trust the Haas, man.
Yeah.
Just trust it.
I don't understand, but he knows the timings, obviously.
He goes home. He studies charts of what the DPS of a Reaper and an SCV combined. He's like, okay. If I
Jack attack that math.
Yeah, exactly.
He's doing great, though. I feel like Marine Lord's in great position, though. The way he has his bunker.
Wait, Chris.
Gosh darn it, Jeff. He is in great position. Marine Lord, I believe in you. You can do this.
You know what's funny, too?
He didn't kill anything.
Yes. Something Rotterdam said earlier, by the way, the next level here.
Yeah, he could have killed other stuff. It does look like he has a Twilight down, but will he see it? Please, Marine Lord, go to the right just a little bit.
No, he'll even lose the scout.
No!
He'll never see it.
And now...
What? It's not Dark Templar, right? It's got to be Blinkstalkers.
I mean, why would you go Dark Templar when you have an Oracle and he's going to make turrets
Chris,
anyways?
Chris, don't ask those...
Because he's
going to
do it.
Your questions are based on logic and these weird...
Rules.
Western things to say.
Haas lives in a world of no rules. He's like Neo from the Matrix. He doesn't believe in gravity.
No.
He can literally make that jump on the first time.
Think not of the spoon.
I just saw that movie recently, too.
It's a great movie.
It is a great movie. Thank you.
Yeah.
I was watching with someone. They did not like the movie. I was
Can't
appalled.
Believe he was dead the whole time, too. That's the weirdest part about the Matrix.
Indeed.
It's going to be Blinkstalkers, and if you're thinking to yourself, this is going to be an expansion and then Blinkstalkers, no. This is four-gate Blinkstalker.
I could see him eventually throwing down a Nexus, perhaps at a gold base. Like, that's the only way I would see. Oh, okay. Thank you, Haas.
Everything
I'm just
going
to leave. You know what we should do for these casts for Haas?
Just let it go.
Yeah, no comments.
Just let it go.
Just play the video. Flo does the observing. Maybe she types a word or two, and that's it.
Could try golf analysis. I like that. Actually, just like very quietly coming in, like, he's going to blink up in the high ground. And a beautiful blink. Beautiful blink up here. He's shooting the SCVs. Was he being serious?
I think so. We did it. And then there was nothing. There was nothing.
All right. Well, Marine Lord's got to like this position better. He sees an expansion. He has
he
not seen anything that blinks. But, Chris.
He barely missed the Twilight.
He did. But at this point in time, it's not a timing attack. It's not an all-in. Like...
He scans the Nexus, which means that most likely he's going to move down, though, right?
Unless he cancels the Nexus. Don't do that to me.
No, he won't cancel the Nexus. If he cancels the Nexus...
It just got scanned. You know it's in his mind right now.
I don't know. I want to like make like a comment, like I'll eat something, but...
Don't.
I know
You'll
I'll
end up eating it.
Yeah, I know. People have to eat Haas.
We're seconds away from this. I actually have this weird feeling.
No. He's going to complete it.
He's supply blocked, though. He actually has to finish it now.
Yes.
Okay. It disappeared off the production tab.
Yes.
I felt my heart go like, no.
Haas completes it. And I think Marine Lord's going to wait until Stim, and then he's going to push down. Because that at least gives you opportunity to pick off Stalkers if they don't have Blink. But he does have Blink. So
what a scary world. Look at Marine Lord. You're so bold. He's going to try to go down to the lower ground and expand.
Playing Haas is like watching a horror movie, except it's first person, and you're living the experience.
Yeah, and it's not a monster. It's like a... It's like a grizzly bear outside.
And you're just locked in the cabin, and you're just peering out the window saying, what is out there?
Yeah.
What is out there? And you just hear growls, scratches at the door. Like right now, he has no idea what is happening right now.
Yeah.
He doesn't know what's out there. But his unit composition's not that bad. Three Marauders. Like, is Haas just gonna let him walk?
Yes, he will.
He's gonna just let him. Oh no, he's gonna see the pylon though. Don't move up that ramp. He's just gonna go for it. He attacks. Good force field so far, but this bio has a lot of DPS. Haas has great micro. He's microing okay. It looks like he's gonna trade pretty well. And now Marine Lord's running for the bush. He's trying to hide.
Get out of
Haas,
here.
The grizzly bear. Two bunkers going up. There's not enough.
He's abandoned the natural.
He has to give up his natural. He doesn't have enough. Marine Lord is up 10 supply.
Don't do it. You can't go up there.
Is there repairs? Is he gonna repairs the bunker, thankfully. Marine Lord's playing so cautious after that push.
And you know what? He's gonna force fuel that ramp unless he just.
Where's the SCVs?
Oh my god, he's going for it.
No. Marine Lord should have this. I don't want to talk because I don't want to be more
I
wrong.
I want you to be wrong, and then I can just come
I
come in afterwards. You're like, oh, this is over, and I'm like, and I wait a second, and then when it's not, I'll be like, nah, Chris. As you can see, the DPS of the combined forces.
This is good trading, Marine Lord. Well done. Like, I honestly
Haas
don't know.
24 harvesters versus 41.
An engagement happens, guys, and as casters, usually you like look at it and you're like, oh yeah, this person's gonna win or this is gonna happen. Everything,
stay, Marine Lord.
Everything doesn't make sense
stay.
To any of us
don't
right
go.
Now.
Why are you out of your bunker?
Yeah, but the medevacs, they help a lot.
They do, but put everyone else in the bunker. Like, I would be the first, if I was one of those Marines, I'd be like, no. Guys,
I want to go there, in the cabin.
I will come out to the medevacs. Let me stay in the bunker for now.
Yes. Everybody wants to go back into the cabin.
No.
Looks like Marine Lord, he wants to move out
don't
again.
Don't do it.
It's 28 workers to 41.
Yeah.
He has a huge amount of stalkers. There's a good amount of bio.
He has stim now, though.
He stims up. He pushes out. He had stim before and he got crushed.
Yeah.
It's 80 supply to 58. By any logic, math, any physics.
Science.
Something.
Just all of science.
Something that we do not know about. Marine Lord should win this game.
He's that's up, where you're wrong, Chris.
He's up 25 supply. Please. Please win.
Wait until that comeback double proxy Oracle strategy starts to take shape.
There's no way. I will eat a hat if Marine Lord loses this game.
Don't say things like that.
I will eat a hat. It's put in the books. Put it in the books.
Chris, you're a bold man.
Yes. Yes, I am.
What kind of hat are you thinking?
Like this tiniest baby hat I've ever seen.
Yeah. Still would suck, though.
Yes.
Dark Templar.
No. It doesn't make sense.
What's the line? What's the line we have to say?
There's turrets up already. There's one in the main.
Win behind. Finish it.
No, I'm not going to do it.
All right. Well, you're about to eat a hat, so.
No.
Marine Lord's going to move out to a sea of Blink Stalkers. And look, Haas actually saw this, by the way. He's heading back. He's going to intercept this. Yeah, it's perfect.
No. Haas, AFK.
It's moments like that where you just have to be like, guys, what is going on?
I hope there's like seasoning.
Because you know he doesn't have observers. Like, how did he know?
I don't know. It's the feel. He can smell it.
He's like, oh, you want to do
attack. He's a grizzly bear. He's literally a grizzly bear. He can just smell it.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, it doesn't look as bad. It's 37 workers to 45, 102 supply to 80. Haas has pylons scattered across the map. It looks like he's playing battleships. He just throws them.
Yeah.
And
C4.
Yeah.
You and sunk my medevac.
The DT shrine has just completed. And you think, oh, Terran's going to push out. I should probably get back and defend. Haas? That's okay. I'm just going to have my units
look
out
the
on the map.
The army's mid-map.
Yeah. He doesn't. Nah.
It's time to decide. And the hallucination goes and sees the army coming back.
Get in the bunker! Get in the bunker!
Haas knows this. He's going to pick up all the detection. You watch.
No.
You watch.
No. He's got scans and stuff. What is this game?
Can't blink out here. There goes
gets
that
the turret.
Turret.
First Medivacs. Turret goes down. Medevac goes Medivac. Down.
Oh!
Okay. A little loss. A little loss there. Not big of a deal. Haas is still in decent position. And more importantly, he's bought time. Because he has no big tech. He has no Colossus. He doesn't have Storm. He has no upgrades.
By the way.
He has no charge.
Yeah, watch. It's not even 3DTs. It's going to be like 7.
Oh, my
I'm telling you right now.
I don't get it, man. I really don't get it.
Here they come.
Oh, my gosh.
And he's out on the map. Why would you ever leave your base?
You see them. You see them. I know you saw them. He saw them, right? Yes, he saw them. Marine Lord saw them.
Stay.
He knows that there's DTs. Yes.
Just
okay.
Just stay and max out on Marines and Marauders.
Small clap.
He's going to drop. The drop is good, by the way, because it's too much for a photon overcharge.
Okay. Does he even have
DTs?
A mothership core? Let's be realistic here. Does Haas have a mothership core?
The
he does
no.
not have
the answer's
a mothership.
The answer is literally no.
Oh,
the answer
my.
Is literally. I mean, why? That's defending. This is over.
I hope so. One DT's being warped in, a bunch of zealots, Zealot's going to tank shots. Looks like the DT is going to go to work. If he scans, that Widowmite could actually hurt that Bioforce quite a bit. He's going to micro away smartly. It does pick it off, but what is there? There's three Zealots, two Sentries, one Sentry goes down, and now there's only three Zealots. He's not going to kill that Widowmine all game. He will literally die to that one Widowmine because, of course, he doesn't have a Robobay. He lost the Stargate. He has nothing.
Robobay is almost as funny as that one time you talked about a third Nexus.
Yes.
It's like it's just as preposterous.
Yeah, I haven't seen him make a Robo ever.
Why
I
would
think.
You?
I don't know.
Immortals? No.
I'm trying to think, but this game just it destroys my brain. This Blink's going to clean up this push pretty well. Three workers going down. Widowmine doing a good amount of damage.
The weakened Stalkers. Nice play by Marine Lord. The Widowmine killed the Stalker and wounded three others, and then immediately targeted those guys.
No hat eating for me today. Right now, 140 supply to 62. Yeah. Haas, I will eat a shoe and a hat if you won this game now.
Be
but
careful.
Not going to happen.
Gets to a certain point, and actually you're just
kind
of
whole outfit. Whole outfit, man. He's going to try to buy time. He does break down these rocks. Zealots are going to be there to help defend. But even if you got a DT in, I don't get it. There's two turrets, there's one in each mineral line. What is that DT going to...
It's too much. The medevacs are muscled up here. Bioforce is fairly well upgraded. They're
he's
gonna
getting
have
Storm.
In a second.
He's going to have Storm pretty soon.
With one Templar.
With literally one Templar. No Mothership Core. No Sentries. He's getting an armor upgrade. It's like Haas is like, what is this? I don't know what to do quite. I've never been in this position before. Any GG's out.
GG is called.
I'm going to have a heart attack.
Marine Lord... He may have won that game, but he has to be in the same mental state where he's just like, oh my god.
I almost lost that game. Literally almost. Like, he was in panic mode. He moved out. He felt confident that he had the army just to step on the map, and Haas just had a huge, huge overwhelming amount of Stalkers, and he almost won the game.
The Stalkers did not... I mean, if he would have had a kind of... There was one missile turret in the natural. He didn't pick that off. And then he went up into the main base. He got a couple of medevacs, which was nice, and a missile turret. But, imagine if he... I don't know. Yeah, and this fight was crazy.
In this moment, it was like, Marine Lord's up in so much supply. It looks like he's going to be able... No. Blink Stalkers. Has incredible Blink Stalker
micro.
And he just cleaned up. And now, all of a sudden, despite the supply, 48 to 60, look how big his army is. Marine Lord has to sacrifice his natural. He has to lift off. And that was a smart choice. If he tried to hold his natural, he would have lost that game.
Oh, and actually, I didn't see that. That's Combat Shield he could have picked off there as well. But, I mean, that would have probably lost him the majority of the Stalkers, which is his lifeblood. Haas has to be shaking his head. He's like, that's exactly why I never expand. It never should have got to that point.
Should have just made borders.
He gets up to five or six medevacs. It's completely ridiculous. My six Blink Stalkers, three DTs, four Oracles, five Void Rays, and a Tempest have such a tough time with that army composition, you know?
Yeah, we're still waiting for that Tempest.
I think you guys are going to wait forever. I think Haas goes right back to his golden. He's like, nope, it's going to be Proxy Stargate. I mean, the first game it worked so well. Like, Marine Lord really did not look like he had any idea how to handle it.
He thought it was a proxy gateway for sure.
That's true. Yep. But I wonder if Haas identifies that.
I don't. When you say anything about Haas thinking or me thinking, it's like you're talking, what would I think an alien would be thinking at this moment? Because I have no idea. I don't even know if he speaks any language from this planet. I saw him in Taiwan, signing to each other, and that was it.
Yeah. I have that, you know, that picture of, like, the Labrador dressed in, like, a lab coat in a science lab? It's just like, I have no idea what I'm doing.
Yes.
I feel a lot like that's going on here, but he's like, he has every idea of what he's doing. The thing is, we are the Labradors.
The professionals, the analysis desks, the guys that have been playing this game for literally...
No, nothing.
5 or 6 years.
We're all Jon Snows.
Nothing.
All right. Well, guys, it is tied one apiece in this winner's match. The loser of this will drop down and face Igaz to decide who will come out number two. Lower left-hand side from France. It is Milord. Milady?
Milady. And in the top right, the great cheeser. It is Haas. Try to do it kind of Dutch-like. Haas.
Yeah. That's interesting. Yeah, the Huda thing.
Huda Guda.
Literally, a dog in our family is named Guda, but it's not. It's a lie this whole time.
I wonder if you called it by the Dutch name, it would come or not.
We'll find out. I'm gonna
test it. Experiment. We are those dogs in the science lab.
That's exactly right.
We have no idea. All right, Cactus Valley, four-player map. this has to favor. Please,
you
please
said
just,
it has.
Just. Oh, okay. I thought you were laughing because I was going to say it favors someone. It favors Marine Lord.
Oh, yeah.
I hope. It's double guess. As expected, Haas is going to probably go for a proxy Stargate. I imagine he'll put it in between. It'll either be like at the 6 o'clock position or it'll be at the 9 o'clock position. If you look at the bottom left of the map, see the mini map, vision a clock painted on it, and then assign a number at the 6 and the 9, and I assume the pylon's going to go down there, and I'm going to guess it's going to be the 9?
You are a far braver man than me, like all these predictions you're making.
I'm a, yeah, like casters, they never want to commit to something. I am committing.
No. Casters can make predictions, that's fine.
But they're like vague.
In a game like this, though.
I don't know. What is this plan? Isn't it too late to proxy something because you scout like this? Like, the core is done.
Chris.
You should be putting up a Stargate right now, and you don't even have a pylon out. He only has 5 probes on the gases, and he's building a mothership and a stalker. Is it possible he just takes a Nexus?
Of course
is that
it's
in
possible.
The, that is possible.
Yeah, if Shia LaBeouf or Nike have taught me anything, it's just that you do it.
You do it.
He's going to scout up here to make absolutely sure, and he will see it.
Misses the probe.
The comedy that is this game, the Reaper whiffs right by it, doesn't see this probe. The probe's going to go right down to the third.
That is great control by Haas. He actually scouts the command center. Oh, that's a mistake. Oh, yes, he sees the probe.
Killing that probe is such a big deal.
Yes, because Haas was very tricky. As soon as he saw that command center, he actually pulled back with the probe.
Exactly.
And Marine Lord didn't see it, but luckily he pulled back and he saw the probe, picks it off, and now he immediately builds a bunker. I'm guessing that because he did see that quick mothership core and that quick stalker coming out.
I mean, now Haas has to send a second probe to proxy as well.
And I think if Marine Lord was paying attention, he saw it with SCV as well.
Yeah.
So there's no Nexus for Haas. He's chrono boosting out stalkers. Probably going to try to run past this bunker. The bunker's going to finish up just in time, and 2 Marines will be coming down this ramp to join the Reaper in that bunker. Mothership core can provide a little bit of pressure, and he's going to get a great scout here with this SCV. I hope, for Marine Lord's sake, that he did see. What? Yeah. How did he know? He didn't see the SCV. Did he?
He just knows, man. Listen, Chris, you got this.
No, I don't. Please, help. Jeff. No,
Reaper's going to die, so he's not going to have any map presence because he did
and
somehow
he
know about
that
SCV.
And there was a pylon right there, right across the corner. Mothership core is going to see vision. There's a Stargate going up. The 2 Stalkers running into the main base. Mothership core joining them. SCVs are being pulled. 2 Marines die already. 2 more Marines
he's
coming
gonna
to
join
He's
going to kill all the Marines, and the Oracle's going to come into a naked base. He's not here to kill SCVs. Like, that's what most people would be doing right now. He'll take that as a consolation prize. He's trying to thin out the resistance for the Oracle.
Le resistance. And Marine Lord is in a lot of trouble. He throws on a time warp, and he's just losing a lot of units.
Oh
he is,
God.
Of course,
oh,
on 3
birds. Nice move.
And this is where he can redeem himself. He picks up the mothership core.
Yeah, in a second. This next Marine Lord.
And now, that is it right now.
Oracle gets started right now.
Did it just get started? It just got started. There's another Stalker that comes out. It can add a little bit of pressure. The redeeming factor, he's on 3 barracks. Marine Lord is playing this so safe.
One is a reactor, too.
If he can get out, you know, 6, 7 Marines, he'll be in good shape. You have to remember across the map, Haas on 23 workers, not bad, but he doesn't have a second Nexus, and he doesn't have any tech. Marine Lord has a pretty good scout on his main base, too, with that SCV. The Oracle is almost out. Does Marine Lord have enough to defend it?
That is the question. He pokes up, sees a bunker is about to finish. Even Marauder's coming out here, but is there anything in that mineral line?
That's enough. He should be able to defend this Oracle. It looks like Haas wants to commit to it. Extra Marine coming from the side. He picks up the Oracle. That's good.
I mean, that's devastatingly good.
That's great. And now a Void Ray is coming out, but having that Oracle already taken down, that is beautiful for Marine Lord. It looked so dicey for a while. If he didn't get that surround with the SCVs, those 2 extra Stalkers, that Mothership core, killing Marines over and over and over again as they come out of production, that Oracle would have ended the game. And he's actually going to scout. He sees the Void Ray. He's going to escape with his life.
Great play by Marine Lord.
Yes, that means he doesn't have to burn a scan. He doesn't have to check if there's a Nexus. That Reaper is going to secure all the information he needs. And Marine Lord is just thinking, defend,
missile turret,
defend.
Bunkers.
Yes.
No worry about it. I mean, he's using the second orbital to have more mules, to have more SCVs. So he'll have oversaturation. And that's when he feels safe or has left the game, and that's probably the only time you are safe, is when he'll then take the natural.
Yes, and he's in good position. It looks like he's going to pick off this depot. I wouldn't even risk it. Why risk it? Just let it go. Ooh. Oh, he's going to actually pick up the Void Ray.
Some
he's going to get
control.
It. He's going to get it. And he gets it. And Haas shows a little weakness in his control.
Yeah, he's falling apart. He is having a tough time. Losing that Oracle is a big deal too, by the way, because he's used that in the past to actually be able to spot for the Widow Mines that have been coming out and make them kind of null and void and threaten reinforcing Marines. Without that ability here, and now losing a Reaper, or not a Reaper, excuse me, a Void Ray for free, he's all, I mean, you can see it. He expanded. He's like, okay, this isn't going
to
work.
And the Grizzly Bear takes out his anger on the rocks, saying, you know what? I came here to kill something if I can't kill you, these rocks.
Got the rocks, man.
The rocks are going to pay the price. He keeps Chrono Boosting out. Void Rays. Marine Lord gets another Reaper out. He sees the Stargate making something. Can only assume it's a Void Ray when he walks past it. And now he's going to scout the Nexus too. Marine Lord is playing so good.
Yeah.
And more importantly, he's playing the player. He is not just, you know, playing well in general. He's playing Haas. He knows what he has to do against the specific player.
I do like the... This is the second Reaper, by the way, guys. He lost that first one earlier on. And the second one is him saying, I still really need to know what Haas is doing. Because something you said, Chris, really reminisces with me. Like, the cheesiest thing a cheesy player could do is to play, like, economically greedy. Obviously, we're past that. But all of us, you know, what if he did?
Yes.
What if he's like, okay,
double
I can't do this attack. Double
something.
Nexus.
Yes, that third base.
And you're in your base building five bunkers, six missile turrets, and then all of a sudden you find out, wait a second. He skipped forward, skipped Robo, and has 35 Blink Stalkers on deck. You know, like, you have to be on top of your scouting against him.
Yeah, and Haas is sitting outside his base with sentries, with Force Field. He wants Marine Lord to move down on the map. He wants to shave off some units and kind of climb his way back in. I would love to see Marine Lord just sit in his base, wait for those medevacs.
Yeah. He scales so infinitely better as the game goes on than the place that Haas is locked into. Like, Void Rays do not do well against stemmed million Marines and Marauders.
Yeah, and he's getting, you know, those normal things like tech and upgrades and other units besides Stargate units and Gateway units.
And
he's got a Widow Mine on the way. He's got two medevacs. He's pumping out Marauders. He's got combat shields. He's got plus one on the way. Haas is trying to bait him into that little cliff and then just trap him in, but he's not going
to
get it. He scouts with the Reaper. The Reaper does go down to one Stalker. He's going to peel off one medevac.
Again, no Mothership Core, by the way.
Yes, and he's being very concerned. Yeah, if he has a Mothership Core, oh, is he going to scout it? No, he won't scout it. The medevac does make it out.
That's when we pull him off the stage and go, look, son, I don't know how you're doing, but you're hacking.
Yeah, like the Blink Stalkers.
Here.
Yeah, I don't know what is going on, but he doesn't see it. And that one medevac could seal this game.
Yeah.
Haas just doesn't have anything at home. If he had a Mothership Core, if he had two Photon Overcharge, one medevac, that's nothing. Who cares? But there's... he warps in
Stalkers.
That's not bad, actually. He warps in one or two more. He should be able to hold this off. It's like Haas has such a good feeling for these weird games. To me, it's like I would never know that timing at all. The 13-minute medevac from one base Terran.
You have that engagement, but these Marines are more, you know,
and they got
to
Stim,
handle.
They got plus one, combat shield even is about to finish. He warps in Zealots, he's going to pick off the medevac, and that's the key component here. You do not want it flying away, but it looks like he's going to trade pretty well. He pulls probes to try to trap these Marines, it's not going to pay off. He's going to do a good amount of damage, already picking off two of those probes and trading out with one more Zealot. It looks like Haas might have to retreat soon, but he's staying. He's committing, and another Phoenix comes out just a little too late. Those medevacs already did depart.
Yeah. It does see no medevacs there, though, and I think that's what's tipping him off. But
think so? He didn't pull back. Did he pull back?
I'm daring to dream. The thing, though, is with double medevac, go ahead and warp in your four Zealots. Go ahead and warp in whatever. The double stemmed medevacs is going to be
plus
more
one,
than he can handle.
Yes. Combat shield, plus one. It's just too much healing power. Bio without any splash is very consistent, overwhelming damage, and those medevacs are going to keep those units alive. And here he goes, he stims in. There's only four Zealots, four Stalkers to speak of. He kills two Marines and trades out four Zealots, not anywhere you want to be, and he's going to have to pull probes. It looks like this is going to
be
it.
Yeah,
this
be
is going to be
game.
It. And he drops a mule, even, saying, you know what? Take some cheese yourself, sir.
Has a little bit of something to say with that. Has, you got to make a choice, buddy. You going to lose this game without ever even attacking, or... He's just going to exit out of here.
I think he'll just exit out.
Yeah, he always going to have to in a second here. He's losing the Nexus. Up in his main base, he's warped in a couple of, I don't know, whatever.
Something. Keyword being warped in.
Never
Gateway
been more.
Units,
yeah, exactly.
Never going to be worth it. And he's just going to bleed out here. He looks like he's going for the push, and he sees the army, and GG's out.
And just like that, Haz is out of this series. Marine Lord survives, and I'll tell you what, this will be an experience he'll tell people about for a while. He faced that man right there, who I think someone has to tell him. Yeah, he's out of the game.
And that's the name of the game with Haas, isn't it? Survive. It's not a game you're playing to win. You're not trying to, you know, outsmart your opponent. It's literally survive. And Marine Lord, the French Terran, maybe the Foreign Hope. He still has a chance. He can make it to BlizzCon, of course, and that's where everybody is aiming this time of year.
Yeah, so well done by him. And again, you know, we had a really good time with you guys as well, but it's like, it's a different game of StarCraft when you play against someone like Haz. Like, yeah, you have to be on top of your scouting, and the guys talked about it at the desk. Like, you can blind counter as much as you want what you think he's going to do, but that's when he shows up with something else because he's just so good about playing that cheese game. It's almost like he knows what you're thinking better than you even do.
And it's beautiful. It's I love the analogy you put that it's a grizzly bear, and you're literally Terran holding down. You got supply depots, bunkers, turrets, and you're in your cabin, and you just need to survive. If you survive that bear attack, you will win the game. Just survive. I guess it's going to be on you next to survive. But Haas, what a beast.
I can't wait. Well, I think we've set up that interview. We're going to hear from the young French Terran player who has survived Haas and is advancing to the round of 16.
Thank you very much indeed, Marine Lord, advancing first in his group, Group D, in the round of 32 of the WCS Premier League. Congratulations. A bit of an ordeal to get there, but you're back in the round of 16. Let's talk while it's still fresh in your mind about that last match. Coming into this group, did it ever scare you a little bit that you had the possibility of having to play Haas?
No, the three player, I was quite confident against them. But yeah, Haas is quite scary. You don't know, like, every proto that cheese like him, they don't deny Scoot as much as him. So you have a lot of information and you know how to react every time. But him, he focused a lot on SCV and on Reaper. So you can't get any information, and then it's very hard to deal with it.
Yeah, it definitely was a bit of a tough game, but I mean, you still pulled through, of course, playing a little bit safer in the later two games and just making sure, like, all right, I know what Haas is going to do. We'll just play it out your way, and I'll make sure I can get the win in the later stages. Of course, aside from that, it was three Terrans in the group. Yeah. And so I'm sure all three of you guys were like, all right, TVT, TVT, TVT in your preparations. What was that like coming in? I mean, were you just like, all right, you know, TVT, I'll just play my own style? Because in your first game versus Masa, you seemed like you just wanted to play super patient and just get to that later portion of the game.
Actually, I practiced a lot of TVT for my Jeffinity match. It didn't go well, but yeah. I practiced a little bit this week TVT with Major, but we are both playing mech, so not mech against bio practice, so I wasn't sure if it was good or not. But yeah, I'm confident in TVT when it's not against big Korean, so I knew that if I played mech, just solid style, I would not lose.
Yeah, it kind of felt like it didn't really bother you what you would face in your first series, TVT. Just like, I'm sitting here in my three base corner, I'm going to do my mech build, try to break it. If not, I'm pretty much going to win the game. I do want to ask a couple questions about your second series against Haas. Was there, I mean, the first game, I think the cast has pointed out that you kind of felt it was a proxy gateway, right? Because you scouted his main and he just walled off the rock. So it's going to be very difficult then when you misread it like that. In the second game, there was a certain point I kind of felt like you were just wandering around what's going to happen. The moment you moved out with the bio units and the force fields went down and he had all the blink stalkers, what went through your mind on that moment?
I knew it was totally all in, so I was like, if I can trade decently, maybe I won't die. Then it was quite bad, actually. But I was like, yeah, I didn't salvage my bunker in the main, so it saved me quite a bit. And then I knew, like, his position, I saw that he didn't have a lot of probe. So I was like, yeah, 50-50, no. Let's just play and we'll see.
Yeah, no, I think that not salvaging your bunker was super key. And also not being too stubborn about trying to stabilize on the low ground, you know. Yeah. Like you said, he had no economy, so just sit on one base. And in that final game, well, I guess on this point, you kind of knew what you were going to expect. I want to ask one thing, by the way, as we can take a look at a couple of these key moments. On this moment, I was like quite worried for you. I was like, this could go wrong. But on a certain point, he blinked into your main. He lost a lot, didn't really kill a lot. What I want to ask you about is that's not something I see very often. On certain moments when you're contained, you suddenly make a second Reaper in the game. What's the thought process behind that?
I need to scout because, like, even if Haas doesn't do it, for example, when I play Leader against, not No Name, but like Barcode or any cheesy Protoss, sometimes they take hidden expansion.
Yeah.
And when you're in this case, like, you have a second base, you are staying on your main base, you are dead, you know? So you have to scout a lot, so making a second Reaper, even a third if you need to. But usually, the second one is not expected, so you just scout with it.
And how was the feeling when you saw in game number two and game number three that he just doesn't have a mothership core at home? Makes drops fun, right?
Yeah, it takes. Even with a mothership core, I would like take the second Nexus or the main Nexus. Yeah. Doesn't change a lot, but yeah, it's very weird. I don't see a lot of Porters playing like that.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think anyone does, really, when it comes to Haas. Well, congratulations. Before we wrap the interview, real quick, of course, you still have, I mean, if depending on how far you can go, if you go to the very end of this season, you still have a pretty good shot at going to the global finals too at BlizzCon. Does that really affect you at all in how you're viewing Season 3 of the Premier League, or are you just going to play the same game and just say, you know what, I just want to get as far as I can, show the best I can in StarCraft?
My goal for season 2 was to do top 8, and I did it. And this season, I would like to take the first place. I think I can do it, but I need to practice a lot. Don't travel as much as I currently do, because like I move every week, so I don't have a lot of time to practice. But right now, I think I don't have a lot of events coming. Maybe one DreamHack and WCS, so I can practice a lot and show some very strong game.
So since Liu Bao, your teammate, made it to the final last season, did you guys make an agreement, say, see you in the final? I'll be there too.
Maybe.
That would be.
Aydar and Polt are there, so they are maybe not agreeing with that.
That would be pretty sweet to see. Well, once again, congratulations going to the round of 16. We'll see you in Poland. For now, we have one match left in Group D. Haas still alive, so is Aegis. We'll see that right after this.